Russia says the one-dose Sputnik Light vaccine is 70% effective against the Delta variant. Here's the full story.
Russia's one-shot COVID vaccine, Sputnik Light, shows 70% effectiveness against the Delta variant of coronavirus 3 months after injection. That's according to the Russian Direct Investment Fund, citing the vaccine's developer. The data was submitted by the developer ahead of a peer review. The data comes as Russia battles soaring infections and hesitancy about vaccines at home, while struggling to compete with more established vaccines from Pfizer, Moderna, and AstraZeneca. Countries around the world are deploying or considering administering third doses of Pfizer or Moderna vaccines or booster shots to some of their population, particularly those with weakened immune systems and the elderly. But there's no consensus among scientists about how broadly they should be used. RDIF said Sputnik Light as a booster for other vaccines will be almost as effective against the Delta variant as Russia's flagship two-shot Sputnik V vaccine. The Sputnik V vaccine, widely used in Russia and approved for use in more than 70 countries, is undergoing a review by the World Health Organization and the European Medicines Agency.
The World Health Organization forms a new advisory group, which it says may be the medical community's last chance to determine the origins of the novel coronavirus. Details in this report.
Right now, this is our best chance, and it may be our last chance to understand the origins of this virus.
The World Health Organization announced the creation of a newly formed group Wednesday that it called its last chance to determine the origins of COVID-19 and urged China to cooperate. The question of where and how the coronavirus came to be has become a highly volatile issue and a particularly touchy topic for China, where the first cases emerged in late 2019. Mike Ryan, WHO's head of emergencies program, urged calm amid a renewed bid for answers.
That is a human endeavor to understand a virus that has stopped our whole world. And I would ask everyone, countries, journalists, and everybody else, to create a little space for that discussion to happen.
A WHO-led team spent 4 weeks in and around Wuhan, China, earlier this year with Chinese scientists probing the earliest known cases of the coronavirus, and said in a joint report in March that the virus had probably been transmitted from bats to humans through another animal, but further research was needed. WHO Director Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus said that the investigation was hampered by a lack of raw data and has called for lab audits. China has repeatedly dismissed theories that the virus leaked from one of its laboratories and has said no more visits are needed. But the WHO believes otherwise.
And we very much hope that there will be further missions to China and other countries.
In an editorial in the journal Science, the WHO said that detailed investigations of the earliest known and suspected cases in China prior to December of 2019 were still needed, including analyses of stored blood samples from 2019 in Wuhan. Chen Xu, China's ambassador to the UN, noted that international teams had been sent to China twice already, and that, quote, it is time to send teams to other places.